The full grade center is generated automatically based on the roster of your My Courses site. Here on the left, my students' names are filled in the first two columns, and to the right of their names is some quick information about the last time they logged into the course site. To the right of that is some columns related to assignments and activities I've been assigning in my course. Here you can see I have a discussion, an assignment they submitted, and a quiz. The information in each of the cells of your grade center provide information about your students' grades. Here, I can see that the student received an 87, here I can see they received a 100, and I can quickly jump into their submissions by placing my mouse over the grade they received, clicking the down arrow, and opening up the attempt by clicking on the date it was submitted. The yellow cells with the exclamation points in them indicate something needs grading. I can click the down arrow next to that cell and click attempt to jump in and grade that assignment. For some things, you might want to put in a grade manually, such as participation. You can do that here as well for just about any column by clicking on the double dashes, then typing the grade into the cell and pressing enter. Columns are added to the Grade Center as you create things in your course site, such as assignments, tests, and graded discussions. However, you can also add columns like participation, where you manually put in grades and no submission is attached to them, using the Create Column button in the top left corner. The Create Calculated Column button allows you to take the columns you already have in your Grade Center and do some math with them. For example, if I had multiple quizzes and I wanted to generate a column that showed the quiz average of all of those quizzes, you could use an average column. Total columns are able to add up a bunch of columns and give you a total, and weighted columns are good for things like final grades or midterm grades, where you want to weight individual columns or groups of columns out with certain percentages to calculate a number. The Manage button lets you change the views, colors, and organization of your columns and rows. The Reports button lets you pull up individual reports for each student's performance in their grade center. And you can also view the grade history of when things were submitted and when you entered grades. The Filter button in the upper right-hand corner lets you change your view of the gradebook to show just particular statuses, like columns that need grading, or just look at things like only discussion columns or only columns attached to tests. The Work Offline button in the upper right-hand corner allows you to download your entire gradebook as a spreadsheet that you can work with in Microsoft Excel. You can click on the names of any of these columns to change the sorting. So if I wanted to sort by week one discussion, I can quickly click on the name of the column and it will sort least to greatest, or if I click it again, greatest to least. You can click back on last name to resort by last name alphabetically. This concludes our quick tour of the Grade Center.